62 broke all previous yearly sales records. The classic two-tone coloring and the wraparound windshield would never be seen again in the Chevy Corvette. After 1962, a hardtop version would be available for purchase for the first time, and the iconic flip-up Corvette headlights would be introduced. The traditional exposed headlights wouldn't return for another 43 years until 2005. Bro, this is beautiful. How long have you had it?
Only 8 months.
Oh, you just got her.
I've always wanted a bet, and my son knew that, so he bought it for me.
Would you tell your son that my birthday's coming up?
Yeah. Right, too.
Right.
Looks very factory. I see we've got updated air conditioning and updated stereo. Is that stuff you guys did, or did it come
that
way?
No, I think the previous owner did that.
That's nice. Other than that, I mean, she looks really original.
Not the engine, though.
What's she got in the hood?
350.
Can we see it?
Sure.
I'd love to see it, man. Oh, man, but it's gorgeous. I love the way everything is set up, man. The beautiful oversized radiator, that shroud. Was this car just like this when you got it?
I haven't done anything to it as yet.
It's just beautiful.
Well, would you like to take it for a drive?
Are you serious?
No.
Are you serious?
Yeah, absolutely.
Twist my
arm. I like all my friends to drive it.
Are you? You're kidding me, man.
No, there's the keys.
Dude, rolling behave.
I watched your place for you while you're doing.
I encourage people to drive my car because that's part of the fun. I trust Danny. He's probably been driving cars since he was 10 or 12.
God, I can't believe I'm going to do this, dude.
Oh, no. Are you kidding?
Too kind. I love it, man.
Gosh, this thing is so nice. You get up to about 30 or 40 tons an hour.
Mint a picsa, összefogdossák az egész autót a zsírosújjaikkal.
Customers neglect their cars. A simple routine checklist can save you a lot of money down the road.
History's the inside deal.
Check your antifreeze level for both the winter and the summer. Not only does it keep your engine from freezing, but overheating as well. Maintain properly inflated tires, and you'll increase your fuel economy. Replace your wiper blades every 6 to 12 months for better road visibility.
At Midas, we'll tell you what needs fixing now and what can wait.
Hey, I noticed your car's not in the driveway.
Yeah, it's in the shop. It's cost me an arm and a leg.
That's hilarious. Sorry, should have taken it to Midas. Get some of that Midas touch. They'll tell you what stuff needs fixing and what stuff can wait.
Next time, going to Midas.
High five. Ah, did not see that coming.
It's time to take a closer look at your tires. Get up to $160 back by mail on a set of four Goodyear, Cooper, and other select brands. Tires, brakes, oil, everything.
Mama always told you to eat right. Are you still a mama's boy? Or are you ready to be a man?
I'm ready. Hit me.
Sloppy Joe's.
Mac and cheese.
Grilled cheese.
This is some next level stuff.
Let's build a car out of food.
Me, Mr. Taterpot. Look at this big taco. And we ain't even trying yet.
No rules apply.
That's good cooking. We're about to change the cooking show game.
Epic Meal Empire. Premieres Saturday, July 26th at 10. On FYI, your inspiration network. Piper Battleground Phoenix is all new next on History. Made every day.
After a while.
Yeah,
you guys should put a mirror back on this thing?
I don't know, man.
Hey, guys. What's happening?
How you doing, Mac?
Good to see you. Danny, Mark, and Judy.
Mark.
Hey, Mark. Danny. Nice to meet you.
Judy. This is Danny.
Nice to meet you.
They want to commission a bike.
Oh, nice.
I'm going to leave them with you. I got a few things I got to do. And if you guys need me, holler at me.
Thank you, brother.
Okay.
Appreciate it, Ken.
You got it.
So we're going to build you a bike.
Chopper.
Straight up chopper.
Awesome. One in one my whole life.
A little long, a little stretched out.
Long stretch.
Nice bike to it.
Springer.
Beautiful. Long Springer front end.
Uh-huh.
Now, what motivated you to do this bike?
I was in the Navy in the 70s.
Well, thank you for your service.
Thank you.
Absolutely. Appreciate that.
Served on the USS Belknap. And shortly after I got out, the Belknap was involved with a collision with the John F. Kennedy.
I don't know. I did the same thing down here. Damn.
I'd like to propose a toast to my new friends and to my best friends, the Chesters, and to the Barnacle for all the fun she's given us. We've already won.
Cheers!
Yay!
Thank you.
Sons at 8 presents The Comedians.
If you're having fun, I'm having fun.
The jokes are still coming, so don't move, slip, or fall. You're watching Icons at 8 presents The Comedians on Movies.
As the boat delivers on the start, we want to wish each skipper and crew the best of luck.
just made it.
Mm-hmm. What did you say to me? Don't move the food in the freezer.
Thank God for my best Spanish. Todo se va afuera.
Everything
out.
Is all new next on History Made Every Day.
Not only is the bike stunning and gorgeous, but what we're getting ready to do is pack on a trip.
Oh, yeah. A few months ago, Mark and his wife Judy stopped by the shop to have us build them a custom chopper to pay tribute to his brothers who lost their lives in a tragic accident on the USS Belknap back in 1975. Shannon's gone crazy building a gorgeous soft-tail chopper, and Ryan's concept for the paint on this bike is stunning. I am so proud of this bike, and I'm so proud of what it stands for. We really want to make a special delivery for Mark and Judy, so we're meeting them on the California coast. We've got the bike stashed in a secret location, and I know Mark is really going to appreciate it.
What a beautiful ship.
Isn't that something else, Mark? Battleship Iowa. Brings up a lot of thoughts, huh?
Yeah. Quest permission to come aboard?
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
Feeling pretty good so far?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Look like she put you in heaven having four boys.
You were how many years?
I spent 2 years on board.
2 years on board?
Yeah.
It's a long time to be on the ship,
yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah. Get to see the world.
Right, but you had a nice tan.
Not when you're sitting in a dark radar room.
Yeah, no. Well, speaking of the radar room, how's your radar doing right now? Feeling anything on this ship?
No.
I think we might need to call some friends on.
Yeah?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
All right.
Hey, everybody, you guys got a few minutes? Come on over here for a second.
Oh, man.
These are surviving members of the Belknap. Right here with you, man.
Okay.
Doing great.
Thank you guys for coming.
I can't believe y'all came.
Seeing all the friends and shipmates was wonderful. And most importantly was Captain Jacob. He is very special to all of us. I am so glad you could make it. This is for you.
Thank you for everything that you've done.
Thank you for all the lives you saved that night.
Thank you. My job. This is an absolute honor for us, man, to be here with you guys, be here with the captain.
It's incredible.
Are you all ready to see this bike?
Yes!
Are you ready? Are you ready to see this bike?
Okay.
I tell you what, man, let me help. Come on, Shannon!
Oh, my God. That is unbelievable.
I am absolutely thrilled with how this chopper turned out. From the Springer front end to that soft tail frame, Shannon built an amazing bike. But the star of the show is Ryan's beautiful artwork. From all the classic naval imagery to the structural diagram of the Belknap itself, each image has a story to tell. This bike is a fitting tribute to the brave men who lost their lives and every sailor who ever served on the USS Belknap. I'm honored to have had the opportunity to build this one. How you feeling, Morgan?
Overwhelmed. That is unbelievable.
Yeah.
respectful honor of the men who died aboard USS Belknap, November 22nd, 1975, and all their names. With this, they'll never be forgotten, will they, guys? When they brought the bike around, my heart almost stopped. It just brought back so many memories of all the shipmates, those present and past. It's all there. It's beautiful.
I got something else for you. I believe you need a little bit of gear when you get out in the wind and ride in this bike. Since this thing is built to work, we got some stuff that's built to work for you as well. Our official Counts Customs jackets from Dickies.
All right.
Your own Counts Customs jackets. We're not done. We got Counts Customs jackets for everybody. Captain, it's indeed an honor, sir. Absolutely.
The collision happened 39 years ago, but it's always very close to the surface. To see the memorial, not only to the people we lost and we mourn all the time, but it's also a memorial to the great ship. It's a beauty.
Yeah, try it on, man. Try it on. What a day today to be able to build a magnificent motorcycle that honors the Belknap and that honors the shipmates that were lost on that ship. To then have a small reunion here, including the captain himself. This has been a really heck of a day. We're honored that you guys brought this project to us. Thank you. To the Belknap, you guys.
Previously on Biker Battleground Phoenix, Cody blows a crucial deadline.
We're not gonna make Daytona with a red bike. Not happy with that, dude.
Doesn't know where it is, and he can't make a decision about anything, so it just keeps piling up.
It's almost like a museum when you come in to see all those things.
I brought Mom here, and I can't leave her here unless I know it's safe.
Susan, you're not running the show.
He's going to clean it out, and then...
He's been saying that for years, Mom.
No, he's going to do it now.
Doug's house on the beach could actually be worth in excess of $500,000. But in its current condition, it's probably worth zero. It's a rat's nest, to be very truthful.
I do not believe that Doug is aware of the severity of his situation.
I would like to hear from him that he's sorry, that he never got me home to live with.
You're making a promise to come live with you, and yet this is what we have.
I wish you were a man.
Yeah, why? You gonna punch me out?
I'm Doug. I live on the beach in Southern California in a mobile home just walking distance to the water. It's a pretty easy life.
But for Doug, a semi-retired salesman, the gorgeous view just a block down the road from his mobile home stands in stark contrast to the one inside it.
This is my house. Been here 30 years. Had enough time to collect a few things. But I think we should start at the front of the house, and I'll show the whole enchilada.